Hello everyone, my name is Saokosal. Today I'm going to talk about how to cache data in the internal storage in Android. Actually, I created a library for you. It's going to be easier to do that. And it can serve a lot of purpose, like you can cache JSON data from the internet and store in your internal storage and use while there is no internet, you know, like that is offline, then you can just use the data and display the data offline. So first, I would like to introduce you my YouTube channel. This is my YouTube channel. And please subscribe for more video. And you can see a lot of tutorials, some in English, some in Khmer, but make sure you find the English one. And this is my GitHub. So to use the file cache, which is the name of the library, you go to github.com/kasalgig and you go to repositories. You should find file cache. And you can see the tutorial here. So first download it. So let's hit download, open it and unzip it. So you can see the same code here and the library here, or you just need the file cache, just copy. And then you go to your project, and this is my project. And then you go to project here and you will find app and libs. So right click on the libs folder and paste it here. Okay. Then you right click on this and add as library. Okay. And you can go back to Android. And you can go to Gradle. There are two Gradle files. And the second one, you should see the line here, lib/filecacher.jar. It means that you added correctly. And now you go back to the project. In Java file, what you have to do is called the filecacher. And if you don't know, you can follow along the tutorial here. So now you want to cache some string. So you need to add a generic type like this. Make sure that when you read and write, you get the correct type. So this is a string, but it's not limited to the string. You can cache array list of any class, or maybe hash map, or maybe some other text, you know, like because it's a generic type. That's all. And then you can call string cache, and then you can write some data here. So here you can say some text, you know, and you need to catch an error. It's called IO exception, because sometimes the internal storage may be broken or maybe error, you know. So you can add your toast here, you know, like say that there's something wrong. So let's put it this way. And then if you want to read it, you can just call string cache and read. That's all. So it needs another error exception. But to make sure that you read it correctly, you have to check if the string cache has cache. So sometimes you don't have this, so you might have some error. So test something like this. Okay. So for now, I want to return it to a string. So like this, log D. Because I want to use the log, so I just declare the tag like this, get the name, and here I can say tag and the text. So if it is working, then you're gonna see some text, you know, in the log below. Okay, main activity. As you can see, now you can see some text. Okay, let's say you delete it, because imagine you are using offline, you know, internet. As you can see, you can still see the text. It means that it cached in your internal storage, and it can work in another activity as well. So let's create another activity. Choose blank activity, and I call it sub activity, and choose hierarchy here. Now in your sub activity, you can do the same. First, you create a file Kasia, then new file Kasia. So you call this, so it's contact, and the file name should be the same. So now it's some text.txt. So if you use the same file name like this, it means that you use the same cache. So be careful if you are using the same name but a different thing, it can conflict and it can cause your app not responding. Okay, so you have to make sure that this is the same cache that you want to use. Now let's call read. Okay, I don't have to check because I know, but if you want to check it, you still can do the same. Kasia.hascache. And surrounded by try catch. Okay, let's call string. Text again, and here you have to explicitly give a type as a string. Okay, and then maybe you can do the same for here. So give it a tag, it's easy to do the work. And I want to open the sub-activity from here. So in the content main here, I have a button here. So just go to main activity, and this is the event here. Okay, so I just call intent, new intent. And you want to go from main activity to sub-activity. Plus, and you start activity like this. It should go to sub activity when you click on the button. Run again. As you can see, the main activity is some tags. Now click on the button and call the sub activity. As you can see, you can still see the sub tags here. It means that it casts in your app. And you can use another method. For example, if you want clear cache, you can do it. Okay, I just call clear cache. And it doesn't need any parameter here. So call it. Okay, call main activity. As you can see, there is no cache here. And if you go to the sub activity, there is no cache. Okay. And one more thing that I really want to share is that because you use the same file, but maybe you are confusing and you accidentally use it, and it is a string, and then in your sub-activity, maybe you use like maybe ArrayList of string, for example. You do something like this. It's the same file, but a different type. And let's say I do the write cache, some text again. And you thought that, okay, you get the same data, and because you don't know the type, and you may accidentally use like this, and you will see something happen. Okay, now in the main, you see some text again here, but let's go to the sub-activity. As you can see now, the app is broken. If you go to sub-activity, you will see the text here, and it says class cache exception. It means that you cache it to the wrong class. So I recommend you to cache another exception, which is class cache exception. And you do like this, and you might add your code here. Then the app will not be broken, and you can see the message here instead. Okay, let's go to the sub-activity. Now you can see the app is not broken, but you see the message here. So you can handle the message yourself, okay? Because the cache here, you know, they say that the string cannot be cached to ArrayList, so just do it yourself. And if you want to see the whole cache, you can call the file cache manager. Okay, you can see the complete code here down below. Just copy. So what it does is that it will get the context of your app, and then it can display your path. It can check your files, maybe one or more files is exist or not, and you can retrieve all the name of the files. And let's do the log here. Let's run it. Okay, main activity. Now you see the path of it. So it is in data, in your app and files folder, and the file name is some text.txt. If you have more than one file, then you can see more file here. And you can delete all the file as well. If you want to, you call manager and delete all file like this. But it will be gone, all the file will be gone. So make sure that you want to delete all the file, otherwise don't use it, because these caches will be deleted while your application deleted. If you think that it has a lot of cache, so you do delete yourself. If not, just leave it there. So that's all for the video. So make sure that you subscribe my channel, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you.